enable. UBM India, one of India's premier B2B exhibition organizers, recently organized its flagship engagement program targeted at the pharmaceutical industry, India Pharma Week. The week-long engagement included exhibitions along with the CPHI and PMEC India. Stakeholders from the industry were offered ample opportunities to network and conduct business, partake in the medley of captivating events that included key discussions around the growth of Indian pharmaceutical industry along with India Pharma Awards, the biggest celebration of success in India's pharma business. With the overarching theme of raising the bar, it is believed that businesses that empower women can empower businesses by having an all-inclusive culture of diversity. Women luminaries from around the world on a common platform share their success stories, experiences and knowledge revolving around three core pillars: leadership, entrepreneurship and gender diversity.
The celebration of diversity is a proven business model for success, and it has supported women's liberation in business. So how can we, as women, thrive and flourish within today's business setting? That's one of the questions I'm sure we will explore today.
What I'll do is I'll request Manisha to take us through. I think that's the dilemma most people in academics have, who have a very stable, very nice, lucrative research job in the academic setting. What decisions that you need to invest in, because it's a bold decision, to give up on an academic career which promises you, the path. She could have been a professor by now, to give that up and join the industry, which is apparently tough.
We didn't give much thought. It was just, I had their support and just the excitement to do something else. So I think that moment, my career took precedence and it was the best decision I made, you know. So I think my learning really has been to, this whole woman want it all. I don't know if anybody can have it all. I think men or women, it's always situational, very relative, what makes most sense to you. But they are your choices. So I think for me, the key was that excitement to start something new.
What would you do differently, if at all, if you had to go back in time? And some of your experiences, especially you had some tough situations with, as you moved up the corporate ladder. So if you could take us through those.
When I actually moved into this whole career, the journey of motherhood, that is the time I had my own challenges. The company's priorities were entering into developed markets. And there was a lot of travel that was required. You have to go through those pregnancy 9 months. You have to go through your own challenges and turbulences in your mind. And you have to manage expectations at home. You have to manage priority expectations in your corporate, at the organization.
These are, always you need to see, beyond your comfort zone, beyond your capacity. Always you need to be a, thinker, learner. Okay, that will really, set you to a very high level. This is what really require.
Most companies, even today, they do not hire women either as freshers or at responsible positions, because we have to go to the manufacturing plants, which are not so sophisticated as corporate offices, And I have been through phases where they didn't even have washrooms for ladies, in some of the plants, because it was a totally, men-oriented, and only male, employees were there. So, but that did not stop me from visiting those plants, and I never thought of quitting that hazardous area.
Yeah, so maybe I will invite Nithya to kind of comment on pharmaceutical marketing, at least in India. This is my perception. Maybe I'm wrong. But I've seen that this is really a plum post. It's a plum lucrative job, right? That's where males like to fight and get that job. I mean, especially vice president pharmaceutical marketing. This is where all the action is.
So it was it was not an easy choice to make, right? I still am the only only senior team member in the India business team. But I think it was about setting credibility, establishing credibility very quickly. So that once you do that, then people let you be. And the way to do it in most situations, I'm assuming what applied to me applies to me in other situations as well, is I think maybe for a brief period, you will have to compromise a little bit, right? You might have to put in those long hours initially. You can always compromise. You can always balance over the weekend. That's the other thing I always keep telling myself, which is that, you know, balance is not something you achieve in a day. Balance is something that you strive to achieve over a week, over a month, or over a period of 6 months, right?
How do you think for women leaders today, this component of self-awareness, how critical is it? And how can, if you have any key takeaways for the team, for especially the young talent over here who are budding to be women leaders?
I think what's really helped me is having a very strong support system outside of work to keep me sane. Work's been excellent, very challenging, lot of good opportunities. But your social structure outside work keeps you very, very grounded. So in West there, you know, I'm not afraid to ask for help for my son. If I'm traveling overnight, I have friends who I can go to who can pitch in. So in West, in that structure, who can support you, be it family, in-laws, husband, you know, you have that structure. Secondly is I'm constantly, and I think it's the academic background, learning. So I put my hands up for all possible courses. Working in a company which values women and leadership, I've had the opportunity to go to Wharton, say, for a financial management course, women's leadership at Boston. So I think that constant learning from others, you know, and I beg each one of you, as you go back, you are championing your own cause, you have women in your organization, connect with them.
On that note, I thank this wonderful panelist once again. Thank you, Nitya, Ujwala, Manisha, Rajni and Vinita. What a pleasure it has been to interact with and this amazing audience as well. I wish you good luck.
The India Pharma Week initiatives, you know, it was more driving about how the pharmaceutical industry is trending, you know, towards very patient-centric and science-centric reformation, which enables a lot of drug manufacturers, formulators to participate in the global market as well as succeed in the regulated market, which overall the globe is striving for. And we own the leadership here, so that's very fantastic.
The third edition of Women in Pharma featured scintillating discussions like Can Women Have It All? Balancing Life and Work, and Strategies to Make Our Organizations More Diverse and Adopting Inclusive Leadership, amongst many more.
What we wanted to talk about today is some insights into how we grow women leaders in organizations, focusing on the pharma industry. And we wanted to give you some insights on personal journeys of each of these people here on the panel. So it's going to be far more of a experiential and a personal journey conversation today. But before we jump into that, what I really wanted to do was to get an understanding of what inclusion means. We've been talking about diversity, we've been talking about ratios, but we want to focus on inclusion.
For me, inclusion is look at talent, look at the positive attitude, and even sometimes if they do not have the relevant experience, with the right attitude, with the right encouragement, they can do very well.
So for women in pharma in India, I think it's terribly relevant to talk about diversity and inclusion, because the range of differences between two people sitting at the same table, even if they're women, just because they're Indians, just because they're in pharma, or two men sitting at the same table in that respect, or a man and a woman. And one of the major aspects of diversity is obviously gender, because that's very visible. It's because you have visible differences and invisible ones, and gender is a very visible one. So that's what we're talking about today.
Women bring a diverse opinion. We have customers who are women. A lot of people who use our products are women. And all of that led to the fact that if you don't have a business case, then this good-to-do thing is not sustainable and it really doesn't make sense. So it's not about policies that say we have to have X percentage on the board or we have to have X percentage while hiring. We have policies like that in our organization as well. But it's really about the fact that it is about genuine business impact.
I would like to actually add to what Jyotsna just said, that yes, organizations have moved a long way from what we were in the past. And again, MNCs probably are a little ahead in their journey. And for example, I think GSK, which is my company, has the first woman CEO in the pharma, global pharma industry.
What do you see as the challenges that the pharmaceutical industry faces in just having more women and growing more women within our organizations?
So what are the challenges really and what are the reasons? One, of course, is the awareness and sensitization, like I said earlier, about the concept of diversity, not as a good-to-do thing, but as a thing that has business impact, is just evolving. And it's coming new to all of us. We need to change mindsets. The biggest mindset is that there's no inclusion of male leaders in this mindset. We need to include male leaders in this conversation. It's a new conversation for them to have. And that's a very, very big challenge.
We are a biotech company ourselves, and we have a huge manufacturing workforce. So we've got shifts in which women can choose to come in shifts that suit them. So I think that's a big move for a manufacturing organization, welcoming women engineers and biotech postgraduates, R&D folks out of biotech school or postgraduates, postdocs, expats from the US coming in, and still being able to blend in with your male colleagues and having a say.
If you see nowadays, we have a lot of women who are excelling in these fields. Again, it boils down to encouragement. We as women leaders need to be the flag bearers and encourage talent and give a slight push to our women employees to do more, grow more.
It's very important that we do that unconscious bias training, not just for diversity, but otherwise also. But very importantly, if you have a six-month policy, it has no teeth. It has no teeth without the unconscious bias. It has no teeth without the maternity reintegration policy, as well as facilities that the organization can put together.
It's making sure that the employee still feels like she's part of the family, and enabling her so that she can contribute all that she could, whether or not her gender, you know, kind of comes in the way, just because she is now a mother. Should that come in the way of her career progress? Certainly not. In fact, that should be something that enables her to do even more, even better.
So here's my suggestion. You don't have to go to HR at all. You don't have to go to your HOD at all. You can do it yourself. We have to learn as women to stop asking permission for everything under the sun, including what time we wake up in the morning. Okay? So, I agree completely. It's as much our responsibility as women as it is everybody else's. We need to take charge.
As part of the recognition and networking stream of the India Pharma Week, the sixth edition of the India Pharma Awards brought together industry champions, stalwarts, visionaries, and organizations from the pharma universe.
So after the spectacular success of the five editions of this unique initiative of UBM India, the India Pharma Awards is back in all its glory, standing tall and formidable, celebrating excellence and innovation in pharma domain.
And the finalists.
The India Pharma Awards ceremony started with felicitations in the category of excellence in ancillary pharma services. The award for excellence in ancillary pharma services category went to Caliber Technologies. Boehringer Ingelheim was adjudged the winner in the excellence in brand, product, consistent performance description category. In the excellence in brand, product, new launch OTC category, the award went to Halewood Laboratories. Glenmark Pharma was adjudged the winner in the excellence in brand, product, new launch prescription category. In the category of excellence in contract research and manufacturing, the winner was Piramal Pharma Solutions. The award in the excellence in corporate social responsibility, companies with turnover less than 500 crore category, went to Hetero Labs. The award for excellence in corporate social responsibility, companies with turnover more than 500 crore category, was given to Fermenta Biotech. India Pharma Awards not just honors and recognizes excellence among the country's pharma companies, but also serves as a platform to honor achievement of individuals within those companies. In the category Excellence in Export Promotion, the award went to Fermenta Biotech. Lupin Ankleshwar Unit was adjudged the winner in the category Excellence in Health and Safety. Abbott Healthcare India received the award for Excellence in Marketing OTC. And the award for Excellence in Marketing Prescription category went to Wockhardt Merrin. The category Excellence in Patient Outreach, the award was given to Cipla.
When it comes to
Cipla was also awarded in the category Excellence in Pharma Digital Innovation. Parley Global Technologies won the award in the Excellence in Pharmaceutical Machinery Instrument category. Cost Functional Improvement, the award went to Abbott Healthcare India. Advanced Enzymes Technologies was the winner in the Excellence in R&D Development of New Product Technology category. In the category Excellence in Skill Development, ECG Worldwide was adjudged the winner. Abbott Healthcare India won its second award for the night when it was declared winner in the category Operational Excellence Manufacturing. In the Operational Excellence Supply Chain category, the award went to Dr. Reddy's. Fermenta Biotech received its third award in the Pharma International Excellence category. In the category Make in India Enablement, the award went to Astrid Life Sciences. The Lifetime Achievement Award was given to D.B. Modi. Dr. S.V. Veeraman, who won the Industry Crusader of the Year Award.
It is the fifth year of this such awards year from UBM, and it is a fantastic experience.
It's a very good platform to showcase our efforts.
The process followed was very fair.
It's an unexplainable feeling that I'm having and my team is having.
It is always very nice to be recognized by the industry peer.
People from Mumbai like us really like it. The arrangements were pretty good.
Gives us a boost to innovate and grow further.
South Asia's largest pharma event was full of power-packed and dynamic engagements. This event was successful in connecting the global community to bring out solutions to pharma industry challenges and establishing superior standards within.
focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.